Goodbye Boolia. Next, Mount Isa.
Boolia traffic, Charlie Yankee Fox, Trot Cessna 1723 miles to the northwest of Boolia, departing upwind off runway 32, climbing 6,500 feet for Mount Isa.
That's a pretty big operation out there, isn't it?
Oh, it is. It's a big fly and fly out operation. So I'll just let them know we're passing by, even though we're not within 10 nautical miles at the moment.
Okay.
Traffic the monument, Charlie Yankee Foxtrot, Cessna 172, in company with Echo Hotel Sierra.
There's a lot of mining activity in remote outback Australia, so it's a really good idea to check your RUSA and NOTAMs before you fly into an area. You really don't want to get caught out if there's blasting in progress.
That's most pleasant for flying, or safest for flying up in this area, is also the season where you get a lot of haze, which is why it's always best to fly early in the morning, when you've got less turbulence and also less of that haze build up. And look, you can see we've got an inversion. So what's the
An inversion is a reversal of the normal behaviour of temperature. So in this case, we have cooler air trapped under warmer air, which is a certain recipe for a bumpy ride.
It's kind of bumpy here at 8,500 feet, but we need to travel an even number plus 500.
In general terms, health is a big thing for pilots, isn't it?
Hugely important. And do you know what the most common cause of incapacitation for pilots is?
No, not carbon monoxide?
No, gastrointestinal disorders.
Is that right?
Yes, tummy problems. Yeah, particularly because travelling and then eating the wrong food and then having barley belly or
something
like that.
Drinking the ball water.
Yes. So particularly for commercial pilots, but something that all pilots should be aware of. Be careful what you eat because you can't take to the air if you need to be running to the bathroom.
Absolutely.